Hi.
Hi, Chris. Oh my God, you've been having a hard time. Jesus Christ, so much shit going down, huh? And you're getting pissed. Yeah. And you don't know how to deal with it when you're pissed, right? Do you yell and scream and shit, or you hold it all in?
I cannot even explain it.
Oh man.
But it's getting really serious. I mean, the entities are really possessing me, like. Sometimes they really pull through me. They used to talk, but not as it wasn't as strong as before. I mean, before it wasn't as strong as it is now. Sorry, and they can move my body however they want. Just keeping going like this for I don't know.
Jeez. Well, we've been looking over and reviewing all the different things you've sent to us, and do you want to tell them what you decided and thought?
Yeah, like I think like it's probably best to focus in on the one thing, because in a lot of sessions we like address a lot of things, but we go from this subject to this subject, and we're always sort of scratching the surface but never digging really deep into the core. And maybe by missing the core, we cause more problems, because like now they know that we targeted them, and they don't want to be threatened to the fully, so they find forces and start fighting back. So like, the PDF file you sent us with the whole list of all your stuff, we can address that and like just go one at a time. Yeah, we can probably like do more, but like you know like just deep, really deep into one thing.
And the one thing.
You mentioned that, you know, having, like, other entities in your body, like, you know, feeling like there's reptilian in your body, the shadow being in different things, focusing on that, like, sort of, like, who's controlling you and all that.
Okay.
Yeah, what can happen is, like she said, you know, when we address this, if we don't get it all, we might handle some stuff on the surface, but because we didn't get out, it'll come back, and then we address this. And it comes back, and so we may have triggered more stuff, and so now they're all over the place, all over, you know, bugging you. And so the strategy we thought we'd go with today, if it works for you, is that one on the first one on the list, this entity that you feel like is in your body, this reptilian thing, and we just go straight at that. And then whatever else we have time to do in this session, we'll go for. And if not in this one, the next 2-hour session on May 22nd.
Okay. So we're doing layer after layer after layer to get to the core.
Yeah.
So it's some serious shit, man. They're definitely, you know, messing with you really bad, and we feel for you, man. It's a lot. So. With that said, is there anything else you want to tell us about this one particular entity and shadow thing that was, and that
well,
reptilian in your body thing?
Yeah. Well, the shadow being, I mean, I met it just one time, just one. Sorry. When I saw him, I just told him get the fuck out, but just. Started to sort of touch me in a way and vibrating my body. But I think I was out of body. I was still laying down, but I just woke up at that time. And right after, I think I just got back to my body, but maybe it entered inside or got out. I don't really know. I'm just confused because I think that it's the same entity. Because sorry, because they are confusing my mind. I cannot really speak properly, even in French. I'm having a hard time right now. I sort of smell something really bad. Like it really stinks, and I have a weird taste in my mouth. But it's the same. I think it's the same smell as the shadow being.
Okay. Now, the shadow being. When you say it as shadow being, is it the same thing as reptilian that's got into your body? Same thing? Two different beings or entities?
Well, I was just suspicious. I said reptilian, but I might be wrong. But my theory is that they are controlling my cortex, in order to make me move, you know, because the cortex, the cerebral cortex, is functioning in a way that, I mean, is managing the movements, the reasoning. I mean, the ability to think properly, and they just, and the consciousness also. So by hijacking that part of your brain, they really have a sort of great amount of control over your whole body. So
okay, I think we have enough now to focus in. Yeah.
Yeah, and you know, if you want to mention anything else about it, sort of like being that's controlling your body, feel free to share like, you know, like a few more details, and I'm good to go.
Oh, yeah, a few more. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, we're getting tuned in. We're getting it that whatever this entity is, whether it's a shadow being of some other thing or reptilian, we will find out more later. But the effect, it's kind of grabbing on or controlling you from the cerebral cortex, taking over your body control, and it's probably messing with your perception of smell and taste as well.
Yes.
This sort of stuff.
And also, yeah, and also my memory, you know. I just said it last time and the other times, but they sort of like, they shut one part of my consciousness in order to just like put a lot of thought, like bombard me with thoughts, or even just when I'm thinking about something. For example, if I think about reading a book or whatever, they just take the thought for a moment, and when I, so I'm just like I just have a sort of amnesia for a few minutes, and right after they just put it back, so that I'm, whoa, what am I doing? I was supposed to read that book, you know. It's really annoying.
Yeah.
But it's getting more serious than it was just some weeks ago.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, can you feel this being inside your body, like, you know, like inside your head and controlling your body from inside?
Yeah. I can hear it. I can feel it. It starts. It gets balancing. You know, swinging me. I just feel like another body is swinging every time, or I don't know. But I think that I mean, this is another thing. But I think that during my sleep, they make me agree to several contracts, or because I remember once I was. During my sleep, I was tortured, like I felt an immense amount of pain, and I said yes to something, but I don't know what. But I know that I said yes, like I was really shouting, and I wasn't pain, and I said yes, but I don't know what. And I think that they do it all the time.
Okay.
So either they do it during my dream, in my dream, sorry, or they get me out and... I don't know, send me in the lower astral or something like that.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. All right, well, guess I'm good to go to check out.
Mm-hmm. Or, yeah. Yeah.
All right.
Good stuff.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Wow. It took me a while. As basically, like, a lot of them were blocking it out, and... It's like a warrior, like we're beings are trying to like sort of strangle me, make sure like I can't get close and all this stuff. But I was getting close, and like it seems like you're not the only one in the physical body here. Write down the number, or like let me write it down, I guess, because saying it in English is a bit harder. But I think it's 102,410 beings inside of you.
Well, like, can you repeat?
Yeah.
102,000.
Yeah.
410.
410.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how many beings have found in you, and it seems like, you know, every time you go to sleep, that's where you become more vulnerable. You don't have the consciousness, and that's where they make you like, and sort of like not an empty vessel, but like a welcoming vessel where a lot of beings are being invited. So
yeah.
a lot of them, it's like a soul trap, and a lot of beings are being caught from wherever and thrown in you. So now you're filled with 100,000, like 102,000 beings, and you're walking there, and all of them are in your body, and they want to get out. Like, you know, like that thing, like, you know, like the thing you say to the entity, like, get the fuck out, that's how they feel, like, you know, like, I want to get the fuck out of here. And they're constantly trying to move you, and, like, they're, like, fighting each other, they're, like, trying to, like, push each other, like, get out of your body, which is why you see, feel those sensations, like, all these movements that you have. It's not just your one entity, it's, like, 102,000 beings, like, trying to move around, like, trying to get out, like, really hard.
Why are they stuck? I mean, why can't they get out?
A lot of them, just like humans, you know, like, they lost their memory, they have no power, so that's what they believe, and they feel trapped, like, you know, this is their, like, sort of hell, or sort of, so, like, a soul trap or whatever. They're, like, trapped inside of you, and they have no knowing of how to get out, you know.
And what can we do to make them wake up, like...
Yeah, wake them up, pull them out, like, you know, like, I can break their contracts, make sure, like, I pull them out and stuff, and just find a place where they can regain their consciousness, awareness, and, like, memories of the past and different things, but, yes. You know, one thing is, like, getting them out, second thing is seeding and make sure, like, no one else gets to come into your vessel.
Yeah, and another thing is we can get the backstory. What made you vulnerable in the first place, or what happened that allowed that to happen in the very first place? But
yes.
We'll look at all of it.
Yeah.
One thing at a time, whatever Ogbila thinks is the best way to go forward.
Yeah. So I guess, like, first getting the boundary of your body would be best, I guess.
Yeah. Is there anything else you'd like to tell us about what happened, the struggle you were having? Because the needle was just going like this. It just kept going and going and
yeah,
going.
Yeah, like, it's the first time, like, I, like, get out of body, and usually I have visuals, and this time, like, I get close to you, and it's like entering the black hole. Everything's sort of slow-mo, there's no visuals, no nothing. I feel like there's a hand over me, strangling me, like, I'm about to choke, and I'm like, damn, like, there's, like, hard to breathe and all. So, like, sort of fighting with invisible forces until, like, sort of able to clear them out, like, sort of, like, get rid of a few things, and then, like, oh, that's what's going on. Like, but
yeah.
It was intense stuff.
Yeah, that was all the way up. It started at like 3.3, and then the needle, and it just kept going and climbing all the way to 4.3. That's a lot, and it just kept going this way. The needle just kept going this way and this way. And so I knew you were having some kind of internal battle fight thing.
Yeah.
So me and Chris, we were like, don't say anything. So finally, something popped. When I said that right at the end, did that help?
Yeah, I was like, I finally, like, sort of, like, you know, seeing, like, you know, finally got inside, like, sort of, your vessel, like, looking at, like, who's that specific, like, being, and I was looking for the shadow being, but I'm noticing, like, instead of the shadow being, it's, like, tons of little bit particles, and there's tons of smaller, like, not so smaller, but, like, tons of little beings out there, like, trapped, and they're, like, they're really hard, like, trying to get out, fighting each other, pushing them around, like, you know, like, they're, like, really sort of trapped in the body, and every single movement you have, there's sort of constant fight inside. They're trapped and they want to get out.
Yeah, you know? And it's not like they're bad guys trying to possess humans being caught and shoved.
Yeah,
they're
yeah.
just lost, in fact. They're just lost.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Wow, that's some heavy shit.
Yeah.
So, let's get back to, for example, like, before entering the nut house and the period where I was... when I was in the nut house, like, did I make any contracts? Because they really manipulated me, and it's like I agreed to things like out loud, because it was different than I am now. You mean? I mean, you know, now I'm conscious. I can talk properly. I mean, not think properly, but you know, I'm conscious. But at that time, I wasn't that. It was like I was dumbed down. To say anything and do anything, so maybe it related to this period, to that period. So it was 1 year ago, just 1 year ago in April, March, April and May, or during my teenagehood, because of my sexual addiction, my depression, maybe the feeling of being lost, and so it can maybe have created agreements, you know, I'm lost, or I feel alone, and we're going to help you, or maybe I'm lost, and they're like, yeah, I'm lost too, can I enter, you know, something like that, or even maybe in childhood, or just way before my incarnation, you know, it's really difficult, like, to really focus on a specific period and find the right agreements or weaknesses. I don't know what else I can say. But it would be good to look at at 1 year ago, like the period of the Nut House. Maybe I made agreements, or maybe this year, I don't really know.
That's okay. What we're going to do is continue what she found the area to address for right now, and we still got a lot of work to do on clearing, waking those entities up, and once we get this part done, then we'll look at the next thing that you would to look at. Okay.
Sorry, I was going overboard. I was going overboard, but
no, that's okay. There's a lot of stuff you're dealing with here.
Yeah.
So.
And you know, like I think I can find connections. Like you know, like what's the period of time when they started coming in and why? So like you know, like I can do it all together. I think.
Yeah. Yeah. It's probably related. Most likely. So Ogvila will get back to work here.
Yeah.
We will. I'll guide you. And
okay.
We'll be ready. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, seems like we can finally start connecting the dots, but I'm looking like when did these entities like beings started coming in, and I'm talking to them and they're saying like, you know, hey, we're being like more and more of us are being thrown here every night. So every night you fall asleep, you're being pulled out of your body, and what happens is that you meet with your higher self out there, and the higher self is trying to serve you for the greater good and make sure like, you know, like, hey, you want to connect your missing soul aspects, here it is. And basically that higher self is not necessarily you or part of you. It's basically more like hierarchical dark force entity. Like, I'm higher than you, so I'm your higher self. And this is like standing in sort of control, and basically I'm gonna be over you, and like he's control, sort of trying to control your life. And the aspects of our beings that are being caught from somewhere else in the multiverse, they're being thrown to you. So they're not necessarily your aspects. It's more like other beings who are being like sort of stolen parts are dropped into you, and like wanting to connect to your higher self and the missing soul aspects. That's where that higher self comes in and basically starts messing with you and like just dropping tons of other beings inside of you.
Yeah, it's like it is a self. You're a self. You know, you're yourself. He's herself, I'm myself, he's himself, he's a self, he's a higher self. He's using a different definition, but the same word kind of thing. It's a deceptive little trick that con artists use all the time. Yeah. And this would explain, too, your high interest in understanding the higher self that we were talking about last week. So it's coming together. We'll get it all sorted out. So what else did you see?
Well, sort of that higher self is basically trying to mess with you, and like sort of since you opened up the connection, he's more like, yeah, he's really willing to connect and help you out, but in what way, that's a whole different subject. And now like he's like catching up lots of different beings out there, like missing aspects, and they're not your parts, they're basically from other beings that like sort of like got messed with, and now a lot of them are being thrown at you, but like that happens every night. You're being pulled out and sort of like opened up like a gate, like, come on in. I want my missing soul bosses back, by the other beings.
Okay.
Is it related to the heart feeling? You know, maybe it doesn't. I mean, they aren't part of my body, so I feel like it's sort of virus or you know an intruder inside my being.
Yeah.
Is it related to that?
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
So I have some strange bodies inside mine, and that's why I feel these hard things.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so do you have a strategy? You know what you're gonna go look into?
I'll close the connection with that higher self. Make sure like it's not bothering you, and then I'll basically pull all those beings out of you and wake them up to make sure like they have consciousness and they get back to their original source, and then do the cleansing. No.
Yeah. Could you look into the relationship between that higher self, what its motivation, intention, what its game is, why does it do this, and why did it pick on Chris or choose Chris?
Sure.
Okay. While you're doing the other stuff, too.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, I was like removing this higher self. Basically, it's not just you that he was targeting. It's like going for everyone where they, you know, whoever they, it is in the world, if they're looking for the higher self and they're like lost and they want more information and connect to that sort of knowingness. That being is like, I'm gonna help you out, but the help is way different. Like, you know, like it's not specific. And, you know, people want knowledge, people want information, people want to get better, find their true self, find their purpose and stuff. And it being like, it's gonna shove it, like, you know, like, it's gonna feel like, oh, I'm getting something, so it's gonna be my purpose. And actually they're being shoved with other, like, beings that's gonna fill them out with fake purposes, fake goals, fake information, which is, like, not theirs, that doesn't belong to them, and now just fills them up with crap. So, actually the higher self woke up a lot of those beings that were inside of you and, like, got them all out. So they're connected to their higher sources and now sort of clear from that sort of thing. Yeah, like, there's a lot to it.
Yeah.
But I'm feeling right now that they have calmed down. Like, you know, when we were talking, like, some minutes, like, 10 minutes ago, I felt a lot of movement. But right now, it's like, calming down.
Good.
Yeah, me too. I felt headaches, little pressures here and there, and then kind of a lightheaded, dizzy feeling. Because I've been asked, not lately, but I've been asking for help from my higher self, too. Fuck you, motherfucker. Never again. Oh, man. Jeez.
Yeah, like, there are beings that can, like, do... Like, can put the title, I'm gonna be the higher self, and whoever wants to connect, whoever is lost, whoever is looking for something, is gonna be the first one to pop up and like, hey, I can help you out, but, you know, whatever you get is probably not in their best interest.
Yeah, same with God, you know, people asking help from God. Well, if a person doesn't have a clear definition of what they're gonna get, they can get any entity that will, hey, I'm God, I'm a God.
Yeah.
I'll help. And it's others, like, go ahead.
Go on.
And others will have a very clear understanding of God. They'll have a picture of an image. I've asked people, they're Christians, and I said, well, do you believe in God? Yeah, of course. Do you believe, like, he's got the white flowing hair and the big beard, and he kind of sits in the... They go, yes! And so they're praying to this guy all the time. And
there is an entity that looks like that. Feeding from them.
Absolutely, man. Yeah. So, yeah. Interesting stuff. Well, thank you, man. Okay, let's take a moment here to reflect on what are we doing next. Do you have... you see what would be a good idea next from the list that he shared with us?
Well, like, that would be like, you know, like... I would like to ask you that.
Okay, yeah, I just want to see if she had any leftover stuff. But yeah, okay. So yeah, we got about 15, 16 minutes. We can definitely look into something else. Go ahead.
Another thing that sort of pops in my mind is like sort of how like this higher self was literally pulling you out of body every night and making sure like, you know, you become like the open gate for these beings to come over.
Yeah.
So... looking for anything like it, you know, like you wanting to get out or be free. I think like I can see if I can find like any other beings who will try to pull you out, but for different purposes, like to cause any agreements or different things, like maybe, but just saying.
Yeah, well, we were looking at the connection between the various things that were bothering him.
Yeah.
And we got this one thing, the higher self thing. What were the...
And, you know, Chris, feel free to fill us out with your info.
Yeah.
I'm looking right now.
Yeah. Yeah, we covered a lot of ground here. We can look for whatever might be related or something new, whatever you would like on the list.
Yeah.
So maybe I'm trying to connect with some higher aspect because my relationship with people and mostly my family is as degraded. I mean, during my teen years, it was really messy. So that has affected me in a really negative way. And maybe that feeling, you know, feeling lost is just... just because you're distancing yourself and from people, and people are distancing you from them. So
yeah.
Maybe this is related, and if there is any connection, we can look at that.
Yes, let's look at, go. So when you were younger, maybe in your teen years, or when you were having trouble with relationships with your family and stuff, were you reaching and wanting to connect with a higher aspect of yourself, or something like that?
Not really. I was just doing my business, but I was always alone. And yeah, this is connected to a session that I had once with a man and a woman. So they said, when they looked at myself under hypnosis, they saw some sort of plates, like below my feet and above my head, and it was a sort of distance or a limit, or I mean, these plates were blocking me from having relationship with my real higher aspect and with the planet Earth.
Yeah.
So, but I was also thinking, what if these plates, metaphorical, but what if these plates are also in place, but on the side with people, not only the Earth and my higher aspect, but with others, you know, there is
yeah.
a connection to me.
Yeah. Yes. Let's look into that. What these plates are. And whether they're not just here, but also here, and
yeah.
how they're blocking you from relationships, higher aspect of self. And we might want to look into the higher aspect of self. Similarly, you can look to see if there's a similarity. Again, it's a label,
yeah,
and it might be getting you to the right place. You know, I think I understand that you would like to connect with that part of yourself that is divine, powerful, knows more, and is in good shape, and it's like kind of like a part of you that you can go to or connect with that would make you feel more whole. But it's your real divine self.
Yeah.
The is sort of like that, and that's maybe by other labels, but that's what you're, am I getting it? That's what you would like a connection with?
So that aspect that I'm talking about is what you said during the last session in your email. You know, you that imagine you in the physical, not
yeah.
any other aspect that is observing or no, but you that imagine yourself in the physical.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, the lately I've realized that instead of putting labels, you just have to feel love. If you have love for yourself, you don't need to
yeah.
ask any higher aspect for help or anything. Like, I'm putting some affirmation and mental conditioning in my head to say, yeah, I want to be loved. Like, I want to feel love for myself. I don't really need to ask for help of any other being. No, it's just me. If I love myself, if I am at peace with myself, because love is not also an emotion, but a vibration, as we say.
Yeah.
So if you feel at peace, if you feel good, I mean, you don't need to look anything else.
Exactly.
Outside of yourself.
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
That's how I am starting to see it now. So.
Oh, that's great. Well, what I have an idea, a plan.
Mm-hmm.
Looking into these plates, like above your head, below your feet, and see if there's any others, and see how that is blocking him from, of among other things, love, and love of self, and love.
Yeah.
The vibration.
Because I think that the entities and the fact that they are, you know, looking, everything is related. It's like it's starting to be clearer. Like, I mean, the plates that were seen under hypnosis are maybe metaphorical, or they're the representation of a distance, you know, of a sort of a barrier that I created myself, but sorry, they're just taking the thoughts. It's like sorry, I just forgot.
No,
I had something
okay.
to say, but they're just like my thoughts.
That's
I mean,
okay.
I'm freeing myself, so.
Uh-huh. That's okay. We're looking. We're going good. Agvila's going to look more at these plates, whether metaphysical, metaphorical, or real, and if there's any other plates, and how that might be blocking you or stopping you from awakening, expansion, love, connection with whatever that you would serve your greater interest to connect with, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Good thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, start.
Okay. Yeah, so I found like these sort of like places you were talking about, and also like they were working like implants that would create the sort of wall around you, and it's like a two-sided coin. No one can get in, but also no one can get out. So having these sanity clusters around in your sphere, basically they were sort of triggering you and messing with you, but even they, like, you know, even they want to get out. Even they, like, you know, hey, I want to connect with someone else. And these entities would try to get away from you, and they can't. Like, it's like that kind of wall where beings are sort of trapped in your environment, and, like, even entities want to get out from you. So, like...
Nobody wants to be there. It's all fucked up. No. Help me out! Oh, my God.
Yeah, so I go show those implants, make sure, like, you know, like, it's all open, like, remove the entities and allow them, like, oh, hey, you're free to go, like, you don't have to stay here. And open up your channels, make sure, like, you know, like, the energy can go through, and, like, we'll see if it helps.
Yeah, because that's what they said during that session, that, like, the energy is flowing, but really, in a really bad way. I mean, I think we're going to really deep, right, like, today. And to go further, maybe these, I mean, to stay on the connection, on the same track, maybe there is hatred has a connection with these distance and barriers. You know, maybe when I talked about violence in my, it wasn't as much as in films or comic books, but just inside my head during my my teenagehood or just the early adulthood. I mean, I'm 20 years, but like, you know, last year or in at the beginning of this year, you know, maybe hatred and resentment has created, had an effect to create sort of butterfly effect. You know, you feel hate, they put plates because you put the distance and entities that are maybe hateful or, I don't know, are entering your space, and then how can I explain it? Like there is too much negativity, and it's creating different effects.
Yes.
I mean, maybe it's the hatred at first that started that all that situation.
Yeah, that's a very good point. That's a very good point. We only have a couple of minutes, but we can take we can start in on it, and then we'll pick up on it again in the next session.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So we'll. Do you have a place to focus in on that?
Yeah.
Okay. Good. We'll get started. But we'll have to wrap up pretty fast after you do a review.
All right.
Okay.
Let's start.
All right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, like I saw, like at that period of time when you were feeling gate, it's like creating this sort of bubble, like where you're isolating yourself from others, but at the same time you're attracting entities with the same sort of feelings that were like they're isolating themselves from others as well, and they gather around and create a sort of vacuum place between you and others. And even if you let go of anger and start like moving on, these entities still have created that sort of wall between you and others, and they're still there. So like I get rid of them and make sure, like, you know, you have this sort of bubble of sort of like lighter, healthier, like loving energy. And when you walk around others, like, you know, you're gonna feel it yourself, and you're gonna sort of give it to others as well. So like, you know, sort of have the connection going.
Like we really got deep today. It's in the end, it's just lack of love for myself and for others. This is just one word, love.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. Hey, I'm glad we were able to get as much done as we could in an hour, and we are going to have to wrap it up for the next session. But hey, keep us posted. And let us know how it goes, and we're looking forward to getting back with you as soon as we can.
All right.
All right.
And last time I forgot to send you the sort of email or text about circumcision, but it's related, you know, hatred, resentment. So
yeah, It's all.
I mean,
it's all
connected, huh? You still want to receive it, or?
Yes, absolutely.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, thank you, guys. Thank you.
Yeah.
You're welcome, buddy. Okay, keep us posted. Let us know. And you get all pissed off and hateful and want to rant, just write that email, man. Send it over. Okay.
No, I'm not hateful, even for circumcision, because it was like the day before, or yesterday, or the day before. I talked to my father about this. I mean, I have already talked with him about that thing, and he even said to me, yeah, you know, in our family or in our culture, because I'm from the Republic of Congo, in our culture, we do that kind of tradition, but even I, when I saw your hatred, I realized that we shouldn't have done that.
Yeah.
No, things are like changing.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm starting to live, in my terms, I'm starting to live in a new life, and I'm sort of attracting things more, I mean, quickly. Oh, sorry for my bad English, but I'm confused in my head. Anyway, you
sound
get
good.
Yeah. Okay, buddy. We'll see you soon, okay?
Yeah.
You take care.
Well, thank you very much, and have a good night.
Okay,
you too. Bye-bye.